It's time to end drug-resistant TB in children.
J'aime me chanter. Il aime chanter, mais il sait pourquoi il fait ça. Il toujours, il chante plusieurs musiques. Depuis le temps de musique, on l'a observé quelques minutes après et puis il chante.
Normalement, c'est Splenda Joseph. Moi, j'ai 22 ans. J'ai un jeu de blanc. J'ai 22 ans. 22 mois.
My name is Айдай, I am 11. Я люблю петь в свободное время. У меня есть много любимых песен. Люблю танцевать, всегда смотреть на зеркало и любоваться собой.
What she likes to do is playing games, playing together with his mother and his father, and also playing in the school. Precious age is 6 years old.
Zayel souffre maladie et tuberculose. Ça a été environ 9 mois. Il était vraiment grave. Ça m'était trouvé qu'il était difficile. C'est dans un moment que il était éternel, il était dans l'oxygène, il était mal pour lui expirer.
C'est un jour, bon, depuis la fête, il était grippé. Même à l'hôpital, il s'en est arrivé, il est arrivé. Il a fait examen pour lui. Et un jour, je me suis levée, puis je me suis fait tousser. Chaque fois, je suis allée, il était pour lui. Je me fais manger pour lui, puis je me suis levée. Il est venu réaliser que c'est malade.
У меня была усталость, головная боль, у меня была температура, и у меня была боль в левой стороне, вот тут. Сказали, что у меня туберкулез, и мы пошли в туберкулезную больницу.
Самый плохой момент был то, что она пила горстями таблетки. Поначалу у нас было по 14, по 15 таблеток. Поначалу у нее были галлюцинации. Она говорила, что... Я вижу, говорит, у подружки, что вот эти маленькие буквы пробегают через ее руки.
They told me that she has coughing, that she has tuberculosis. So when they come, I'm going to confirm. I'm going injection, tablet. Ni ma di are mo ba ku jin ba bere si. O ni ma di are mo.
Drug-resistant tuberculosis is a huge monster. Childhood drug-resistant TB is a major challenge in Nigeria. Over time, we've noticed an increasing trend of childhood drug-resistant TB. From like 9 cases in 2015, we notified 52 cases for 2018. And for 2019, our mid-year results is showing us that we've already notified 34 cases from January to June 2019.
The impact that drug-resistant TB will have in a family is enormous. Like some of the children that we had seen earlier today, you can imagine a mother who had a business, maybe selling, and then she has to bring her child to come for treatment for so many months. So the impact on the immediate family is there, loss of livelihood for the family, and especially a mom who has to come, and if it's a child that's admitted, she has to come and stay nearby so that she'll be able to look after. And the child is not going to school, is losing school time.
Having the disease is a burden. Now the treatment itself is a burden.
For decades, there were no child-friendly medicines for children with drug-resistant TB. So doctors had to treat them with injections and drugs created for adults.
There was no pediatric formulation, so you had to guess and do your best to make adult formulations work for children. And the worst was, I would say, capsules. I mean, how do you divide an adult dose in a capsule by putting powder, mixing it up, and trying to get the kid to take it? We were guesstimating, and this is unacceptable.
Аларды бөліп, жарып, капсуланы бөліп, жарып, ыңғайсыз болчу да бала ичкенге. Анан біз анда білбей қалчуыз, дарыны бөлсөк, жылысым капсуланы бөлсөк, дозасы фура болды, тура болды, қалды деп, ошонтып, күмән болып қалчу да.
Я потом пожаловалась врачу, говорю, может, какие-то таблетки уже побочный эффект дают. Боялась всего того, что мы не сможем дальше продолжить лечение. Вот чего я боялась. Я хотела, чтобы эти лекарства для нее были как бы легко усваиваемы.
We come from an era where we had to treat with injectables. Inflicting a daily injection to any child, but an infant, for 9 months and causing deafness in children. It was a tough choice to make. To save a child, you had to put him through terrible treatment. It was horrible that we had to inflict such terrible pain to our patients and terrible side effects in order to save a child's life.
On avait beaucoup de difficultés avec le traitement. Donc, on vient de voir HFT. Qui a fait un régime avec un agent injectable. C'était vraiment difficile. Chaque jour, pour piquer, il avait peur de tout le personnel. On était très inconfortable. La maman aussi n'était pas coopérante. Donc, elle voyait son enfant souffrir avec ces injectables-là. Donc, on souffrait énormément de ça. Donc, c'était l'inconfort et pour le personnel et pour les parents.
Ils vont parler 8 mois et demi. Bon, je me demande pour sauter parce que tellement. Et puis, il y a un malade. Après, je suis allée, je suis toujours malade là-dedans. Puis, il y a un maquille. Bon, je fais si bien pile dans les médicaments. Je sais bien. Maintenant, j'aime pas mal les médicaments. Je dis que ça va être pour les médicaments par si mon appart.
Globally, fewer than 500 young children start treatment for drug-resistant TB every year. And up until now, those who did get treated received painful injectables that can cause permanent hearing loss and adult formulations that need to be crushed, broken, mixed, that taste terrible and make treatment difficult. Now, there are new medicines to treat drug-resistant TB formulated specifically for children and all oral regimens without injections.
Il faut qu'on ait des formulations adaptées aux enfants pour garantir non seulement leur mise sous traitement, mais aussi leur adhérence afin de résoudre le problème. Parce que ce serait une grande catastrophe d'avoir un enfant maltraité et qu'il y a qu'il y aura des complications pulmonaires et qu'il ne pourra plus fonctionner pendant sa jeune enfance. Ça, c'est vraiment difficile à digérer et à accepter en tant que pays. Oui, parce qu'on ne pouvait pas avoir accès à ces médicaments. Il n'y avait pas de budget pour acheter ces médicaments.
Non,
c'est pas explicable. Pendant que la tuberculose est curable.
In 2018, Stop TB's global drug facility set up the Pediatric Drug Resistant TB Initiative, aiming to ensure access to the best possible treatments to children suffering from one of the deadliest diseases that exist. At the beginning of 2019, 16 countries had procured these life-saving medicines through and financed by Stop TB Partnerships, GDF.
On avait l'habitude déjà de travailler avec GDF sur les formulations pédiatriques.
We were so excited and immediately we were able to distribute these medicines to the field.
GDF donnait à Haïti gratuitement les formulations pédiatriques.
Through the Pediatric Drug Resistant TB Initiative, programs were able to access and introduce these new formulations in less than 12 months.
We've also been able to build capacity of clinicians and program officers in a number of states with the support of the GDF and the Sentinel project to help improve the knowledge and skills of clinicians and program officers in the diagnosis and management of drug-resistant TB in children.
With the new
introduction of the pediatrics formulations. We are happy because now the children will have a better way of taking their medications. It lessens the health worker's stress on giving the child medications. And of course, the compliance and adherence is improved on the child drug intake.
Ошол Жадеевтин берген дарылары дозалары так балдарга жагымдуу, анан кийин жанагы суда эриген дарылар болгондуктан алардын эффективдүүлүгү бир канча жогору деп эсептейбиз.
Мына лиге медикамент патимна либре ла лес, ком се же дже комон се бен мальге контан либре, либа фелке макар.
You can imagine like a child that has tuberculosis who was all very scrawny, wasted, breathing, with difficulty coughing. And then when you diagnose appropriately and start treating and start building up with nutrition and the proper medications, and the child starts gaining weight. So when a child is getting better, the child starts growing and starts developing better. Then starts playing and smiling. So those are the things, I see that smile and I smile also like, oh, this child needs to go home and join the family.
Большое счастье для матери, когда твой ребенок здоровый и рядом с тобой ходит, улыбается. Это самое огромное счастье для матерей и для родителей, чтобы дети не болели на этом свете. Не только у меня, но и других детей.
We are tremendously grateful for the work that Stop TB and partners have done in really pushing the agenda to get pediatric drugs developed and accessible for countries like Haiti where otherwise it would not be accessible. So it's been a game changer for patients and their families, for clinicians.
On behalf of the government and people of Nigeria, we want to really appreciate the Stop TB partnership, the GDF, and the Sentinel project for the support, because we know that the children are the future of the country, and we need to do all that is within our reach to ensure that they get prompt diagnosis and treatment for drug-resistant TB.
Even if it's one child in a year, as tuberculosis, that child could eventually become the next child that will give a cure in a major breakthrough in health, in our health system. So we can't give up on the child.
Moi-même, moi bénéficié de médicaments, moi bénéficié, ça fait me plaisir, moi content, moi vraiment content. Et me souhaiter que son programme cap continue pour l'autre monde, notre grand monde qui vient pour mal, qui pour souffrir mes maladies ça. Puis on joue un accès à médicaments, sauf continuer à sauver la vie de l'autre monde.
On September 26, 2018, the UN General Assembly called on the heads of states and governments to provide diagnosis and treatment with the aim of successfully treating 40 million people with TB by 2022, including 3.5 million children, and encouraged all nations to use the Stop TB Partnerships GDF. Around the world, more than 200,000 people with drug-resistant TB die every year because they cannot access the life-saving medicines they need. This is not acceptable. By the end of 2019, the Stop TB Partnership GDF's Pediatric Drug-Resistant TB Initiative supported the introduction of child-friendly formulations in 56 countries, providing over 1,100 treatments for children with drug-resistant TB, more than double the number of young children treated each year for drug-resistant TB. The scope and speed of this introduction is among the most successful in global health, but we are still far away from the 2018 UN high-level meeting on TB and the global plan to end TB target of treating 115,000 children with drug-resistant TB by the year 2022, including 47,000 young children in need of these new child-friendly formulations. The global community has the capacity and means to end TB. It's time.